before moving on to the problems, we need to know some important points. That is, generally, when you maintain your cash book, how do you know whether your cash book tells you that whether you have your money in the bank or not? When you balance your cash book and you got the balance of the cash book, that is the bank column balance as a debit balance, then we say it is favorable balance. Suppose if you got the bank column balance as credit according to your cash book while balancing, we call it as overdraft. Then similarly, in a passbook, if your money is there in the bank, your passbook will show credit balance. So credit balance as per passbook is favorable balance. Similarly, when bank has given you a temporary loan, then your passbook will show debit balance, which we call it as unfavorable balance or overdraft. Now, always you remember this while doing the problem. When simply the word balance is used as per cash book or balance as per passbook, it means favorable balance as per cash book or favorable balance as per passbook. Now, I have modified the passbook format for our understanding, better understanding, similar to that of cash book. Now, if you observe here, in cash book, as you know, we have receipts. Receipts is nothing but whenever you record it in the debit side of your cash book in the bank column, your balance will increase. That is what we call it as receipts. Similarly, when you make payments, we call it as payment that we enter on the credit side of your cash book in the bank column. Now, passbook is exactly opposite, we discussed. So that is why this receipts, which is there on the debit side of cash book, I have written it on the opposite side of passbook. And similarly, the payments, which is there on the credit side of cash book, I have written it on the debit side of the passbook. And if you see, technically it is nothing but a simple ledger or what we call an account format. And remember, this is the bank column of your triple column cash book. So when you record any transaction on the receipt side of cash book, your bank balance as per cash book, that is according to you or business, will increase. Similarly, if a transaction has to be recorded by you on the payment side of your cash book, your bank balance according to you or your accountant or your business will come down. That is what I have indicated with arrow up and arrow down for the balance. Now, coming to passbook, when a transaction is recorded on the credit side of passbook, then the bank balance according to the from the bank point of view, your balance will increase. Similarly, when any payment side entry is there in the passbook, from the bank point of view, your balance will come down. Okay, so with this knowledge, we can move on and discuss further what are the transactions that are there in your, that will be there in your problems, which are common. Before that, turn to page 148. You are given a sample format of how to prepare BRS with some transactions, and they are added or subtracted, whatever may be the reason. In such a case, what we do is we will discuss each thing and how we have to reflect here, so that later we will reflect here now, later it can happen without using this. Now, first thing, if you see there, it is given balance as per cash book or balance as per passbook. Here it is, balance as per cash book. So all the things he is talking from cash book point of view. Now, next, overdraft as per passbook, whatever it is, you need not remember or by heart this. If you know how to analyze this, then it becomes easy. Now, if you see, there are some items that are added, there are some items that are subtracted. So with this we will discuss. First, in the additions you have checks issued but not yet presented for payment. Now what is the meaning of a check issued? Check issued means you gave check to someone. So when you give check to someone, you know, naturally you are the initiator of the transaction. So it is a cash book transaction and you are giving check means your bank balance should come down. So that is why we say checks issued are entered in the cash book on the payment side, that is or credit side. In the problems you will find the word checks issued. In place of issued, it may be checks paid, or it may be checks given, in or it may be checks paid out. So this is only nothing but change in the language, but the transaction is same. And you gave to check to someone, it is recorded first in the cash book on the payment side or credit side, as a result of which your bank balance according to cash book will come down. Now next one, interest allowed by bank. What is interest allowed by bank? Naturally, you know, whenever you have money in the bank, banks give you interest. So it is bank who will calculate how much interest they should give you. So we say in this case the bank is the initiator of the transaction. So when bank is the initiator of the transaction, the entry should be first made in the passbook. So when bank gives you interest, your bank balance has to increase. So let us go to passbook and see which side, if you enter this, your bank balance will increase. Naturally, receipt side or credit side. So on the credit side, I am writing interest allowed by bank. It can be similarly interest on investment, etc., etc. Then the third one, interest and dividend collected by bank. It is the same as discussed earlier. Bank is collecting the money what you have to receive as interest from someone or some organization because you have an investment, etc., with them. Dividends, it is given to shareholders when they invest money in shares, when the companies make profit. So as a result, whenever bank is collecting this money, it will add to your existing bank balance, means your bank balance will increase. So simply you can write the side interest dividends on investments oblique shares I am putting. So that is the third thing. Now let us see next what is the item. Fourth item, if you see, direct payments into bank by a customer, meaning your customers have to give you money. Instead of coming to you, they have directly put the money in the bank. So when they put money directly in the bank, bank comes to know about it first. So they will make entry in your passbook. So when your customers have to give money, or they are giving you money through bank, your balance, bank balance will increase, so bank will enter. So this we can say as direct deposits. This we can say as direct deposits.